Aha! We're back. We just unplugged it and plugged it back in again.
I don't think they heard any of that because the microphone's on this.
Oh, okay. Now you can probably hear me because we fixed the problem. Thank you for joining. I'm glad you like it. Happy Z89. It's time to get started. Here we go. I'm going to work over in this corner. Take off where we left off last week. I'm working with the 2B, which is the lightest of my pencils. So I'm doing a lot of like just light pencil line work right now. Working on the frog over here. Gonna use my Q-tip here, do some blending. Give him an extra finger there. I'm gonna go in later and really push the contrast, but for now it's just about putting in a little bit of the tone. Kind of figuring out my layout. Ah, thanks, Kiki Cat. That's in honor of Spazzy Elvis. He's the funniest cat ever. I have to, you know, maybe I'll share some pictures of Elvis. He's been doing this thing, which is really cute. And also just a little bit creepy. I'll show you what I mean. So, like, here, can you see this? I was in the bathroom, just getting ready. And I thought I was being watched, and I actually was. There he is. staring at me in the bathroom. And then there's another really good one. This is him sitting on the other side of the tables. I'm sending emails, just kind of staring at me. So that's this guy here. He is a funny cat. Right now he's actually in the other room. Oh yeah, that's right. He's like leading the board meeting. And I feel like I was in trouble in both those photos. Like, he's judging me. I'm switching to a 2B now to add a little bit more tone. See how the TV is adding just a little bit more tone? I don't have to press as hard, and I'm getting a lot of tone work with it. By the way, that giant box behind me, so you can see it here, is turns out boxes work for kids and cats, because my daughter and the cats have been having a blast with this big giant box behind me. I don't have the heart to throw it out because they've all been enjoying it so much. So pardon the giant box behind me. Just using the tone, kind of. Oh, just knocked my earphone out. Yeah, they just kind of happened. I just kind of let them happen. This is a really fun piece. I was looking through that, the line drawing book that I was looking at when I started and just seeing if there's any animals that kind of like make sense. And this is kind of what I came up with. Having a lot of fun just seeing what happens. A little grouping here I'm enjoying. Like two kind of groups happening here. This is kind of an aardvark. Let's see if I can zoom in so you can see the detail. They're tiny. We can leave it there for a minute. zoom out so you can see. That's what we were working on. So it's quite small. I'm gonna sharpen this and get a better point. Zoom in so you can see. I haven't decided how big his back needs to be. I think kind of like that's good. Welcome back. How are you? Thank you. Is your work schedule better? Oh my gosh, tornadoes hit. How close was it to you? Oh, that's terrifying. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry. That's so scary. Is everybody okay? Your neighbors? Tornadoes are no joke. Oh my gosh. Tornadoes are so hard because you just never know where they're gonna go and they can jump. And when I lived in Iowa, when I was growing up in Iowa, I remember four tornadoes came through. When I grew up in Iowa, I remember that, and I remember the sky turning kind of green. Does that happen? I'm so glad nobody was hurt. Yellowish green. Oh, yeah, I remember that. I remember there being like looking at my skin when I was a kid and going that like this really greenish tint and really quiet. And then the tornado just kind of drops down. I was probably about maybe 8 or 9 when the last one hit before we moved to California. Sound like a freight train was coming above us. Like just like the tracks are right above the house. It's so scary. Do you have a basement? Like a safe basement to go into? Oh wow, yeah, that's what's so crazy about them. It's like you can't really prep for it because you never know where it's gonna hit. Oh, well, I'm glad you guys are safe and your girls are safe and your property's safe. Oh, you're at work. Oh gosh. Well, hopefully there's a safe place at your job to go into. In Iowa, we had there were storm shelters inside the school. I remember that. Let's give this frog a little grin here. Just a really slight grin. Little nose. give this guy a longer tongue. Is that weird frog ear thing? Toad ear thing? Hi, MoCap. Welcome. Thank you for joining. Working on kind of the group. This is what we're working on last time, and now I've just kind of moved over here. There's almost like two separate groups going on here. It'll be fun to kind of pull them all back together as we finish, kind of connect them back. But having fun kind of with this little grouping over here today. Oh, you saw the balloon animals? Yeah. So they're kind of, I have them lightly sketched in here. If I have time today, maybe I'll work on a little bit of that, but they're kind of taking this rhino away here. And now I'm kind of just working on this frog's face. Excuse the yawning. I'm sorry. Couldn't sleep again last night. I wish all my ideas didn't come like at, you know, 1, 2, 3 in the morning. It'd be nice if my brain would just shut off for a little bit. Usually they have these kind of folds on them. Thank you. Giving this frog some muscles here. Thank you. Yeah, we're talking. Oh, that's right. I forgot. Yeah, we were talking a little bit about like pulling tone away using line versus using just tone, like pulling the. So, what I like to do. Well, everybody draws differently, but the traditional way is if you're doing tone, you kind of do the whole drawing in tone. If you're doing line, you do the whole thing in line. So if you were doing a line drawing and you want to do tone, you would do a series of kind of cross hatches. You know, to show that I do kind of a combination of both, which is kind of blending and then line work, and then blending and then line work. So I just build up those layers to kind of define the shadows. So right now, for this guy's foot, all I'm using is just tone. There's no actual, let me zoom in. So for this frog's foot, you see how that's just all tone right now. So if I want to add a little bit more definition to that shadow, I'm going to add in a little bit of line work. See, I'm kind of just separating it a little bit more. I want to push this finger back, so I tone over it. I'm actually just doing like little lines over it now. So you're saying that, so you feel like you're scribbling when you do the shadows? Scribbling's okay in the shadows. What medium are you using when you're drawing? Using graphite? Yes? Are you blending? Or are you just doing with lines? It sounds like you're doing line work. That's graphite. So like, say I'm doing tone here. This is just laying down tone with my 6B, Crosshatching, So crosshatching can look like scribbling. So it's been a while since I've been in a traditional drawing class. I'm trying to remember exactly, but I remember, if I remember correctly. So this would just be tone. I rarely rely just on crosshatching for shadows. It feels very formulaic to me, but, so if I was to do crosshatching here, they want you to be totally consistent with your lines. So I would overlay the tone with the crosshatching. But you're doing it straight from scratch, so you'd be doing like, where's my eraser? Let's erase this shadow. So this would be your shadow here. That crosshatch over it. Ah, that feels very very formulaic to me, but there would be your, oh, I should make it so you can see it. This would be your cross, this is just cross-hatching here. So this is the cross-hatching, and this is the cross-hatching with tone, which is how I decide to do it. Getting all these texts now. This is our last week of school, so I'm getting, all the moms are texting each other trying to figure out what we're gonna do. I really like to do both. I'm trying to think of a way. I guess if you try to stay really consistent with your cross-hatching and just build up layers, but after you build up layers, they start to look messy. Try it with the tone, unless you're trying to get one thing mastered, like you just want to do everything cross-hatching, because that's it's a technique that a lot of artists use. But I like to use all the tools I have available when I draw, so I kind of do my own version of it. I don't know in a drawing class if the teacher would even be like, this is not even how you learn to draw. I think I'm at that point, but I don't really care. There's line, there's contour, there's tone. So if you're doing a tone, you're specifically just gonna do tone, no real line work to it. I get bored with just one way of drawing. I feel like we've got so much at our disposal. I can make everybody look great. You're very flattering, but I don't know if I would have, I don't know if I'd have the patience really to do the whole drawing in tone or cross hatching at this point. I mean, I'd have to really stop myself from all the things that I, you know, just get used to doing when I draw. If I was to teach again, I'd have to kind of go through the courses and relearn each specific drawing style, and then have to kind of practice each specific drawing style again, because over the years I've just combined everything to get what I want across. But I don't think there's a specific type of drawing that I'm doing. Right now I'm not using cross-hatching either. I'm actually just dragging the pencil across the bottom. I'm just going to use this to kind of block it out. This frog, I just watched, is it called Pan's Labyrinth? don't know if you've seen it, but it's a pretty cool movie, and I just kind of remembered that giant toad that's in the movie, and that's where this idea came from. Yes, the Q-tip works really well for smooth shading, especially because this is a smooth paper that I'm working on. But I use the Q-tips even on my semi-smooth drawing paper, my large ones as well, and it works great. I really like the dark shadow under here. It's really anchoring this frog right now, and when I finish this side, it'll have some of that same kind of anchoring happening, but I'm not that side yet, and I don't know what I'm going to do to finish it, so I have to leave it out until then, because once you go this dark, you can't really remove it anymore. And the nice thing about the Q-tip, it's so easy to erase. There's no marks on the paper. There's no lines that have dug in. Let's see how easy it is to just kind of remove it all. Let me see if I can get this. You can see a little bit more of the whole drawing that we've been working on. There we go. Yeah, let's do one of these balloon animals before I go, so you can kind of see what's going on here. I'll start with the Q-tip, actually. Oh, thanks. Have a great day at work. Hopefully I'll see you on here soon. Bye. Kind of the shape there. Kind of wherever the balloon overlaps, I kind of darken that because I figured that's two layers of kind of balloon material. Okay, I think that's it for today. Let's see if we can get this all in. Kind of at an angle here. Come on. My stand is like really stiff to turn. There we go. You can kind of see it all. And we'll keep working on this on Thursday. So thank you everybody for joining, and any questions, you can find me on Instagram, Facebook, and if not, I'll be back on Thursday. Thank you.